welcome to this instructional video on how to work with Easytrieve macros in VS Code. This video will demonstrate how to use macros that are stored locally on your computer or macros stored on the mainframe. Before we can start working with Easytrieve macros, we need to set up the VS Code extension by defining the location of macros. These can be stored locally on your PC or on the mainframe. If the macros are stored on the mainframe, we need to install an extension called Zoe Explorer, published by Open Mainframe Project in VS Code Marketplace. Once installed and configured, the macros in the mainframe can now be accessed. To specify where the macros are stored locally, we need to fill in the text box in the VS Code extension settings where we specify a list of macro locations separated by a semicolon. This can be either a full path to a local directory or a mainframe dataset, as you can see in our example here on the screen. All the specified locations are searched in the order in which they are specified. To access macros stored on the mainframe, we need to fill in the text box in the VS Code extension settings where we specify the Zoe profile which will be used to communicate with the mainframe. The setting can be left empty, in which case the default profile will be used. The construct of Easytrieve macros is such that they can't be parsed as a standalone file, but only within the .ezt file. Let me open an EZT file containing macros. As you can see in the problem section here, there are currently errors reported in the macro file. To go off and fix these errors, you can simply click on the error message and it would open the macro file where you can fix the cause of these errors. Once the error is corrected, you can save the file and go back to the original EZT file. The first error was fixed. However, we're still getting an error message stating the member was not found. In this case, the macro is located on the mainframe. To access a specific macro, you can click the Refresh EZT Macros button in the right bottom corner of VS Code, which downloads all the macros from the mainframe, specifically from the dataset specified in the settings as demonstrated earlier. Once we have downloaded the macros, another set of errors have been discovered in the newly downloaded file. You simply need to follow the same steps as we did with the case when macros are stored locally. Once fixed, the file is saved and uploaded back to the mainframe. For more information on the Easytrieve VS Code extension, please visit Visual Studio Code Marketplace. Thank you.